guys, what's up? It's Joe Rady from Rady's Rides. I'm back here at Land Rover Clearwater, and we have a very, very special SUV for you. This is a 2020 Range Rover P525 HSE LWB. Talk about alphabet soup. We'll get into that in a second. Let's talk about Range Rover. So Range Rover is that premium level of the Land Rover brand, that iconic manufacturer from England, really was making crazy off-road vehicles before SUV was even a thing on anybody's mind. Fast forward to the 21st century, with Range Rover, you're gonna get that sexy appeal, that luxurious interior, but really in a vehicle that's still fully off-road capable. With this particular one, LWB stands for long wheelbase. So this is a Range Rover with a longer wheelbase, gonna give you more room, and it's gonna give you a better stable ride off-road or on-road. So let's go ahead, dive into this very, very special Range Rover. You'll see it's featured in this beautiful flat metallic paint, absolutely just wraps it like a nice tuxedo. You have that very unique but also brand identifiable full LED headlights. LED headlights, daytime running lamps. You drop down, you're gonna have your headlight washers, those pop out. Functional, these horizontal slots, everything is functional here to cool air. And then you even have lower LED lighting fog lamps to help illuminate the road in front of you, and some extra functional side air curtain. A little bit of gloss black, and then we come across that iconic name, Range Rover. My only zonk for this is all the emblems. I wish that they would actually sink these into the hood or just stamp the name Range Rover into the hood. But I love the gloss black design, and this is another brand identifier, this wavy chain link look of a grille. This is something that goes with Land Rover and Range Rover. There's that iconic name, Land Rover, British green. That's a color so synonymous, so many great models, so many great years. We drop down, you're gonna have some functional slots here, a little bit of gloss black. Now we have this in the lower setting. This vehicle sits on an air suspension ride. It's in the lowest setting. You can actually raise it even higher for that off-road duty, but definitely from one corner to the other, very, very massive and very unique in its style. We go up onto the hood, and this flat metallic blue highlights every single body line. You got these two beautiful high rises that kind of curve over, one that's a little bit more faint. And then as we come around the bend, we have some optional wheels. These are drop dead sexy. 22 inch gloss black, 275 on the width, 40 series sidewall. You can see that massive, look at the size of that caliper, massive Brembo calipers with the Land Rover branding script on them. I mean, here's my hand and there's the caliper. It's ginormous. Even the rotors, fully ventilated. These vehicles with supercharged power, you have the horsepower, you also have the braking capability, and with the air suspension, remember, you're gonna be able to raise or lower this very, very beautiful SUV. The way the hood closes forms a nice body line across the fender, and then really, really great the way they take the style of the gloss black and kind of cascade it down, and then it just horizontally goes the whole length of the bottom. You'll see L there, that's talking about that long wheelbase. Wheelbase, if you're unfamiliar with that term, is the space in between the front wheel and the rear wheel. And with this one, those two things are a little further apart, but I love this section here, especially the way it kind of extends out. Gloss black on the mirrors, gloss black on the A-pillars, and that classic flat style roof. It gives it such a unique look, unmistakable. Nice body line. See how I'm telling you how they really think this through with the hood? All the way down the belt line, look at that. And then the quarter window back here, this quarter window, massive in size, nice angular, it looks like one massive just piece of glass, a little bit of gloss black, and then look, they pick up that trim at the rear, kind of extends out, and then when we get to the tail end of the business, super clean. You have a nice low roof spoiler, no windshield wiper, everything is tucked in nicely. That Range Rover badge again, gloss black, Land Rover, we drop it down, P525. Wait until you hear how much horsepower this thing has. Supercharged fun, HSE, you got plenty of ground clearance, and the exhaust is actually, this is actually the exhaust tip. It's a super, super angled slash cut, full tow capability. And remember, this could actually be raised up. But why don't we pop the hood and see what's powering this Range Rover?
All right, guys, we got the hood popped on this Range Rover. You can see the structural bracing that they have on the tops of those shock mounts. You're also gonna get, if you see wires like this, this is adaptive suspension and the air suspension. Look at that engine cover. Not the sexiest, but what is sexy? Two words there, supercharged on both sides there. So what you're looking at is the 5 liter, good old 5.0 supercharged V8, 518 horsepower, 461 pound-feet of torque. It's all made it through a ZF 8-speed automatic transmission. Of course, this has all-wheel drive with a twin-speed transfer box, that wonderful air suspension, and that's what's gonna give you not only acceleration performance, but also your towing capability and everything else that makes a Range Rover what it is. But why don't we go ahead, looking at this engine is okay, let's fire it up and see what it sounds like. All right, guys, I wanted to show off that air suspension. Right now we're in the lowest setting. I'm now gonna raise it up and be able to showcase it going up as we're sitting here. So I hit the button and the suspension, I could actually feel the suspension lifting us up higher. Really, really cool to have that kind of technology and have that flexibility for whether you want to drive on the street and be lower or lift it up and go higher. But why don't you come on inside and I'll show you the interior of this P525 HSE. Leather everywhere. I mean, exactly what you come to expect. I know you're probably saying, well, Joe, how much is this? How much is this crazy Range Rover with more letters and numbers in the name than even the English alphabet? You're looking at $140,000 MSRP. One of the biggest options is the paint job. If you like it, it's around $7,100. Let's see what else you get. Love the two-tone material. You have the cream color leather, the Meridian sound system, the gloss black, all the seat controls there, easily placed, 22-way positionable seats with massage control. Look at the size of that pocket down there. Not only could you put a couple British scones, you can even get a couple good old American hot dogs and drop them in there for your journey. As you go from the door panel to the dash, the leather is so soft. This Windsor leather is so soft. You wanna open up your glove compartment, you have the nice felt lining, you can put the crown jewels in there so they don't get scratched, or you can put the family jewels, but you may wanna hold on to those and keep those to yourself. Open this top one, and that's going to bring this down, and you have even more felt lining. You could put your Twinkies in there and you're not gonna scratch your Twinkie. No guy wants a scratched Twinkie. Close that up, you got your two AC vents, a little bit of silver trim, your start stop button, and then you're gonna have that 10-inch infotainment system screen. What's cool is you could actually adjust the pivot of the screen. So you go into your settings, and this is where you'll be able to adjust that angle. See how I can make it flush, or I can make it stand up if I want to. I like little touches like that, especially if you're paying $140,000 for a vehicle. You got your navigation, Apple CarPlay, Android Auto. You can see how easy it is to use. There we are at Land Rover Clearwater. There's our coordinates if you wanna come stalk us. You drop down, we have more TFT display. Look at this, AC control. That's me, that's you if you were sitting next to me. You could go into your seat controls, do the ventilated, do the heated, do the massage. We could go back into our climate. We could go into vehicle. This thing is like a video game. Look at the settings here. So you wanna hug a tree, you could go into eco mode. Look at that, we're selected. You could, if things are getting kinda grassy and gravelly in the snow, remember how I was telling you this thing is fully off-road capable? Or if you're just gonna drive normal on the street, they got you covered too. For everybody else, your dynamic program. You have your knobs here for temperature, blower speed, but watch this, you could actually change it. So you push that, and now I'm able to adjust the temperature, dual climate temperature, as I get blown away by the wind in here. You got your seat controls, everything else nicely set up. I'm gonna raise it a little bit there. You can see how you can raise the temperature. You push back down, real nice. Super clean, gloss black. This is gonna control that ZF 8-speed automatic transmission. You got Land Rover badge just to remind you, hey, you bought a British icon. Open up this door, boom. Two cup holders and a place for some toothpicks. Here is your Land Rover key fob. Flip it around. There's your buttons on the back. Got your panic button when you're freaking out. Close this up. If you don't want to use the screen to go through your different modes, look at this. Push up this little guy, and now you got a nice little dial here where you could go through different settings as well, or you push it back down. Here's where I was able to raise or lower the Range Rover. Armrest is as hard as a British rock, but I do love the stitch work. We lift it up, look at this. Got a nice little party tray for your British M&Ms. And then you lift that up, and now we actually have refrigeration where you can keep your Twinkies cool. Who doesn't want to put a cold Twinkie in their mouth? That's the big question. USB, 12 volt, seats. This Windsor leather, I'm telling you, it's as soft as a box of Charmin that people have been hoarding. Even same color on the seat belts, nice and comfortable. You have that beautiful Range Rover script down there on the sill. And then of course, you want to have sun? You can have your sun. Look at this. Beautiful panoramic sunroof. Slide that all the way back. Everybody's gonna get some vitamin D. Vitamin D for me, vitamin D for you, vitamin D for everybody. Just like if Oprah Winfrey was giving away the sun. Plenty of room in here. Come on over to the business end though. I want to show you behind the wheel of this Range Rover.
All right guys, business time. On the driver's side, like you saw on the passenger, you got your seat controls, three-way memory seats. So you got three different people that can sit behind the wheel of this Range Rover. The amount of cushion in here is phenomenal. And having that massage capability is great. My only zonk that I forgot to point out over here are these weird captain's chair style armrests. I don't know why you would need that, but I guess when you have everything, what's one more thing to throw in there? Steering wheel, classy, sexy, like you're wearing a tux or a beautiful dress out on the town. Leather, the gloss black, the Range Rover badge. You do have paddles on the back of the steering wheel to go up and down the 8-speed. I am gonna zonk these for $140,000. These should be magnesium. They should be some type of metal, an ore or something on the back of that wheel. Dash though is great. It's a nice 12-inch TFT display. You got your speedometer, you got your tachometer in the center, you got your navigation, and you have a beautiful head-up display as well. Everything this fine leather. I mean, you really are sitting in the lap of luxury in this Range Rover for sure. But why don't we go ahead, let's check out the mid-row and see how your passenger is gonna love this British icon. All right guys, here's where LWB, long wheelbase, pays off. Look at all this thing. It is ridiculous how much room you have in the back seat of this SUV. Of course, you're getting that wonderful, same great leather. Look at these pockets. This is just insanity. You could fill this up with all of the diamonds in the world and just leave it nicely in there. The stitch work is great. You have a super large cubby here. You could put easily three boxes of British chocolate Twinkies in there. 12 volt, which I don't even know why it's there, because look, you have your rear AC, AC controls just like up front, and you have two more 12 volts, a little tiny cubby for atomic fireballs, and then two USBs. AC vents are nicely placed right up top here, but I think really the big thing is the amount of room back here is unbelievable. Armrests, let's see how that goes. Wow, look at that. Two cup holders, you have your cup of tea there and your British scone. We open up this guy, there we go. You could have your peanut M&Ms, and there's plenty of room that you're not gonna crush them. And it's soft everywhere, as it should be for $140,000. But I'm telling you, this is, you want the ultimate SUV? This is it, plus some. But why don't we go ahead, let's check out the back cargo area and see how much stuff you could put in this Range Rover. All right guys, time to open up the back. Now there's actually the buttons up here. You hit that, that's gonna be electric assist. And then you are going to have the loading pad, which is in the upright position. Now, the good news about that is that you can put things in and out, and it's not going to roll out if you're on an incline. Now, there's so much stuff back here, and I apologize for not taking it all out, but I did not want to damage any of these things. Those seats are going to fold down. You have over 123 cubic feet of space. What do we have on door number one back here? You got a 12-volt LED lighting, a ton of room, and then watch this. You hit this button, voila, landing pad. Here's where you can load things in and out as you're working. Maybe bags of mulch, right? You put in the $140,000 Range Rover. But you push that, that closes back up. We push that. If you're ready, I'm definitely ready. Let's see what this supercharged Range Rover drives like.
All right, guys, we're leaving Land Rover Clearwater. We're in the Range Rover, say it with me, P525, yes, HSE LWB. Right away, this thing is so comfortable. The door panel is exactly at the right height that I love to rest my arm on, and because of the leather, it's as soft as can be. Center armrest is hard, but the leather is super smooth and comfortable. And that TFT display for the dash, clear as can be with the navigation in the center. Nicely done. Looking out the back window, lots of space, obviously. You got the panoramic sunroof open, so you're getting the nice light in. I can see out over that flat blue hood. But let's see how she accelerates. On throttle, wow. This thing, I'm telling you, gets up and goes, especially for the size that it is. That is really respectable, having that supercharged power, over 500 horsepower from that V8. It's quiet for a V8. I would like a little bit of supercharger whine, but I'm sure somebody who's going after a Range Rover wants it extremely quiet and comfortable, especially if you're doing long wheelbase. The long wheelbase allows your passengers in the back seat to just be pampered and spoiled. I mean, it's unbelievable, the room back there. But the nice thing is, even with this being longer and larger than most Range Rovers or Land Rovers, it's easy to drive. Super, super smooth. And very, very quiet. Guys, as we're driving here, it's such a serene environment, very calm environment. The beige, not my cup of tea like my grandmother used to say, but it works in here. It with the two-tone, with the black leather and the beige, and especially with that flat blue, it just works in here. And everywhere you look, you're getting wonderful high quality. To have that display for your AC and all the other controls, these are things that you're not gonna find in just any vehicle today. And that's what separates this Range Rover from pretty much anything else out there on the road. Right now, I'm getting a massage. I got a 22-way positionable seat. I mean, what else could you need? Back on throttle, here we go, drops down. All-wheel drive, you got that two-speed transfer case. And then, like I said, the crazy thing is, we could haul butt on asphalt. This could go into full off-road mode within the push of a button. And these things are capable. They're not like, oh, we'll give it all-wheel drive and let you lift up the suspension and see what happens. Like, they are fully off-road terrain capable. I mean, that's what really makes it be a super standout. All right, guys, I want to get us out on the highway, really see how this Range Rover sort of just glides over the bumps on throttle. If we need to merge, let's merge. So you're going to get up to speed really, really quick, be able to get over and not have to wait for anybody in this Range Rover. And there we are. We just kind of glide right over. Super smooth going down the highway here. You have that wonderful head-up display. Nice weight from the steering. And just really, everything else is just really done right, as it should be for $140,000. But like I said, it doesn't feel like a cumbersome vehicle whatsoever as we're driving through this traffic here.
All right, guys, I put it into dynamic mode. Let's see how the acceleration and how she handles on throttle. Wow, drops down much quicker. You are getting quicker acceleration, faster shifts. Look at this thing. Wow. The handling, I'm telling you,
especially because we have the suspension. We dropped the air ride suspension back down to the low position. For a large SUV, it really handles well. That dog right there wants to be in this long wheelbase Range Rover. He's like, get me out of this Kia. I want into that Range Rover. That's what that dog's saying right now. But super smooth, plenty of power. This thing really, if you want the ultimate, you're looking at it. You really, really are. But we're gonna go ahead, get back to Land Rover Clearwater, wrap this one up, so I'll see you in a split second.
All right, guys, it's been an incredible day here at Land Rover Clearwater. Definitely gotta thank Chris, Phil, and the rest of the crew getting us access to what possibly may be the most ultimate when it comes to luxury, style, performance, and off-road capability. I'm gonna say it with me. You better say it with me. Range Rover P525 HSE LWB. This one takes the cake, mind blowing. But if it's ultimate SUVs like this that you wanna keep seeing on Ready's Rides, leave a comment in the comment section. If you're new and you're on your way out, hit that subscribe button. I promise you it's worthwhile. Come back for more. If you are a subscriber, thank you for being part of the Ready's Rides family. If you want to help us keep making great content just for you on the channel, click the link in the description. Get yourself some Ready's Rides merch. Got to get it to Big Guns McGee. Tom, I think this vehicle might be the first vehicle that's too big for you. So, and the price tag, of course. But thank you, Tom, for your hard work. And just like always, guys, I'll see you on the next ride.